initially when I started, I didn't know what CrossFit was at all, and I knew very little about Olympic lifting. So, but I initially found out about it because I wanted to learn Olympic lifting. So then when I came and I was introduced to both, I wanted to do both. I still wanted to do the lifting because I feel like I just have this thing where I want to try to get stronger. But I also realized that the CrossFit was good as far as the muscular endurance and learning other skills. I got interested in some of the gymnastic skills, and it gave me other goals to work on and other things to get good at. And I like the idea of having different durations of workouts. I still like the shorter ones just because I'm biased with that. I hate running, and I still hate running, but I know it's good to do it sometimes.
Up, up, up!
When I first qualified for the USA National one, the American Open, I didn't know anything about them, that everyone that goes to those wears the singlet. At the open competitions I've been to, it's mixed. People could wear a singlet. They might wear just a regular t-shirt and shorts or pants or whatever. But for that, they wear the singlet, so they thought, well, you could probably still wear one but have something underneath, or, we'll talk with the committee. The main issue was that, you had to wear what everyone was wearing, which is the singlet, which is it had to be body tight. And it had to be cut off at the arms and the legs, and no headscarf. So that was that initial issue. And so they said, yeah, you can compete. They weren't denying me that. Said, if you do, you have to wear that. You can't not wear it, otherwise you wouldn't be able to lift. Even if your scores weren't going to count, you still can't participate. I took some time just to think about things and see, well, should I do anything about this or not? And I talked to some people, and, because Olympic weightlifting is an Olympic sport, and the idea of the Olympics is you want to include as many people as you can, and the Ted Stevens Act, I talked to lawyers and things, and they said, well, it's something that you could try. You could just try writing a letter and explaining. I'm just one person, so I didn't really know if I should even do anything or not, but then my story got passed around, my situation, and it got to a human rights group. They do some other things. It's called CARE, the Council on American Islamic Relations, and they said, well, we'd like to help you. We can talk to the Olympic Committee and see what we can do on your behalf.